Welcome back to Upfront. We're continuing our look now at Governor Doyle's proposed early release of nonviolent offenders for good behavior. The governor included this in his budget that's now before lawmakers. His administration says the savings are estimated to be $27 million in just the first 2 years. The Department of Corrections says it costs the state $29,000 a year for each inmate. Prisoners who are released to the community supervision programs cost taxpayers just $2,000 to $3,000 per year. Rick Raemisch is the Secretary of Corrections for Governor Doyle, and he joins us now from our affiliate, WKOW-TV in Madison. And Secretary Raemisch, thanks very much for being with us today.
Thank you for having me.
Let's talk first about who would be eligible for early release. What kind of crimes would these individuals have committed over their time?
Well, for most, it would be those that had committed nonviolent crimes, and obviously sex offenders would not be eligible, nor would those that we believe would be at risk to reoffend once they got out into the community.
Now, but these would include people, for example, who burglarized or dealt drugs. Would they be eligible?
They would initially be eligible. However, as part of this program, each individual that is eligible would automatically have a risk assessment done on them, and depending on how, whether they passed it or not would depend on whether they would move forward in the process.
Are you concerned about the timing of this? There are some who say the economy is tough right now. You're going to be turning people back out into an economy where it's hard to find a job, even with the best of resumes. Are you concerned about that?
You know, it is a concern, but I think we have the proper safeguards in place. We, for those that won't be able to initially find work, even in transition jobs, we plan on keeping them busy, whether it be through treatment or community service or other types of programs.
One of the things that has been touted with this is the cost savings. But we had Attorney General Van Hollen on, and he says it's really not an apples comparison when you're comparing a state like Minnesota, where they do much more of the community supervision, and Wisconsin, where we tend to incarcerate people. He says it's not apples and apples because they have a better support mechanism for their community supervision. Are you confident we have the resources in place to make sure that this is not putting people in situations where they possibly could reoffend?
You know, I do believe we have and will multiply the type of programming that we do have available in the community, and our probation and parole agents do a good job now. And I disagree with the statements about what Minnesota has versus what we have. I think what we can agree on is that Minnesota has 9,000 inmates in their system, and in Wisconsin we have 23,000, and that means that either we have really bad citizens in the state of Wisconsin or they're doing something much different, especially when you look at the crime rates, and they are almost the exact same type of crime rates.
You're a law enforcement professional. You were the Republican sheriff of Dane County from 1991 to 1997. And yet you hear some of the criticism from other law enforcement professionals. What would you say to those who criticize this and say this is bound to increase crime?
Well, also, probably unknown to you, I spent 11 and a half years as a deputy with the Dane County Sheriff's Department. Mm-hmm. 7.5 of those years was as an undercover narcotics detective and also a homicide investigator. I was also an assistant district attorney and an assistant U.S. attorney, and of course I've worked my way through corrections, starting as a administrator in probation and parole, then deputy secretary and secretary, and adding to that a governor who was one of the longest standing, if not the longest standing, attorney general in the state of Wisconsin and a former DA. These decisions and policies weren't made in a vacuum. They were made with a lot of experience behind us, and that includes my experience. So I don't think there's anyone out there, frankly, that has the background in this area that I do and the governor has.
And your law enforcement experiences, the ones you just detailed, tell you what specifically?
They tell me that, first of all, you have to believe that there can be positive change behind bars, and I believe that there can be. If you don't believe that, then let's just keep building prisons forever and we'll never have enough of them, and let's empty our wallets and get on with it. But if you believe there can be positive change under the right circumstances, then you look at what 40 other states are doing, including Wisconsin, which is looking at sentencing reform, and you start getting programs and incentives that will change an inmate's attitude, their outlook on life, and prepare them to return back to the community, and especially when you consider that 97% of all inmates return back into the community. We better have them prepared for that return, because if they don't return prepared with a positive outlook, they're going to return angry, and if they return angry, they're right back in the system with more victims and more costs.
Secretary Raemisch, we appreciate your time today. Thank you very much for being with us on Upfront.
Thank you.
And coming up next, why some people are worried that the number of foreclosures is about to jump in Wisconsin.